Hello class, I am Miss Anna. Today, I am going to teach you using grammar translation method. The native language is Filipino or Tagalog, and the target language would be English. So please listen class when I'm going to read the story titled The Lion and the Mouse. Also, upon hearing the story, list some nouns, verbs, adjectives from the story. Noun is used to identify people, things, and places. On the other hand, adjective is to describe the noun.
What about the verb, Miss?
A verb is used to describe actions. Okay, I'm going to read the story now. The Lion and the Mouse. A lion was once sleeping in the jungle when a mouse started running up and down his body just for fun. This disturbed the lion's sleep and he woke up quiet, angry. He was about to eat the mouse when the mouse desperately requested the lion set him free. I promise you, I will be a great help to you someday if you save me. The lion laughed at the mouse's confidence and let him go. One day, a few hunters came into the forest and took the lion with them. They tied him up against a tree. The lion was struggling to get out and started to whimper. Soon, the mouse walked past and noticed the lion in trouble. Quickly, he ran and gnawed on the ropes to set the lion free. Both of them sped off into the jungle. Now, what's some of the verbs found in the story? Does anyone want to try?
Oh, pick me, Miss, pick me.
Go ahead, Sean.
The verbs that I found are tied, gnawed, and whimper.
But Miss, I do not understand what they mean.
It's okay, Sean. Tied in Tagalog means nakatali. Gnawed in Tagalog is ninuya. While whimper in Tagalog is hikbi.
Thank you for explaining it to us, Miss.
You're welcome. Now you have learned the words that you don't know back then. But you get to know it now. I hope you gain knowledge about our topic today. See you next time!